In the Tribhung, as I learned it from Kelu Babu, the center of gravity, the baseline, is never displaced. So that in Tribhung, the top of the cervical spine will be in a straight line going down right through the center of the body. And so the head movement and the torso movement will never cause the shoulders to shift off of being directly over the hips. That solves everything. So you can't possibly have your ribs going too far because your shoulder would have shifted off the center. What concerns me is something that is not only affecting the aesthetics of Odissi, but putting the bodies of dancers at great risk, which is a total change in the bend of the tribhung, which is that instead of the hip deflecting to the side, there is now a crease in the hip bending forward. The result of this bending forward is that from the front, it looks like a nice tribhung.
Thank you. Bye.